On the third day of Christmas, Nerdbots gave to me 3 gym passes, 2 closet shrines, and a cracking bottle in a tree.
I have Coke.
Yes, that is all we need for a Sunday evening.
Your otherwise, boy. Out of rum and out of Coke, but ready to go here. Here's
the harmonica has appeared on the scene. What's up, guys?
Oh, shit.
We're here for the much prophesized, much hyped episode. The Ecchisode. This is our present to you from the Manga Raiders Happy Hour. What a day of Christmas it is
Happy
going to
birthday.
Be.
Happy birthday.
Yep.
Can we get a voice clip of the prophecy from back in episode 2?
We can. It's going to enter the stream, I was going to say. It's going to enter the recording right now.
Ah, okay, fine. The Ecchisode, definitely. We need to talk about Ecchi because
okay,
tits
Lego
and ass are awesome.
Okay, Lego wants to talk about Ecchi.
Or do you agree or do?
That was cool and exciting.
Yep, yep.
And what a time that was.
That was... when was the second episode?
Man. I was just a young pup, even though I wasn't on that one.
May 2015 it was, if I remember right. Something around that time.
I was still in kindergarten.
I wasn't even born. I was just, you know, oh. I was still living comfortably.
Yeah, you're trying to one-up me now? You're trying to get a little contest
here?
Yeah. Well.
I don't know what you win in this contest. I was just
wondering immortality.
Do you know what I want to win so badly? All I want for Christmas is Ecchi.
Yes! Are you guys ready to commit social suicide on the internet? Talking about the most taboo but most loved topic of all time in anime.
That's an arguable statement.
oh, yeah, well, other than that other stuff, people go deeper.
Don't get after me. I believe I was the... It might be my voice in that prophesizing clip, if I recall correctly. So...
You, I like how you're taking a moral high ground against people who go deeper than you, Lego.
well, I wouldn't say it's a moral high ground. I'll just say it's a light gray. It is a ground. A ground.
It's a small plat. It's a ledge.
It's a ledge. I'll go with a ledge. How are you guys doing?
How is my future self doing? You're gonna have to ask him.
Are we going to ask? Are we asking time travel questions?
Yeah,
let's go for it. Fuck it.
We are currently talking to Kindergarten Manimal.
Hi, this is Kindergarten Manimal.
Kindergarten Manimal, what is your favorite Ecchi?
My favorite is probably freaking Jesus Christ, Mars of Destruction.
And he has rapidly aged into his current self. Kindergarten Manimal, everybody.
Hey guys. Hi.
Hello?
This is the greatest intro of all time. We're rolling so hard right now that I cannot freaking believe how hot this is. I must leave the room. The smoke alarm is going off.
Bring up the heat then, motherfucker!
Okay, well, bring up the freaking heat. Kaijo is great.
We've already done the virtual left thing. Everyone knows who we're here, right? So
no, we don't because we haven't done virtual left. We haven't done virtual left. Let me do it really quickly. Okay, Lego, you can do it.
Yeah, I'm really bad at this. Okay, I'm Lego Maestro, the sort of host here, but everyone's free to throw in ideas. I am to my virtual left is Corin. I hope. Damn it.
Hello guys. I am Corin, and to my virtual left is a man who needs no introduction. One of you was supposed to say something.
Okay, that was not the best setup. Hi, I'll take that moniker as the person who doesn't need any introduction. I am Simon, better known as Voluptuous, Vicious, Vacant. with the dolphin hips and cat ears galore.
I feel vicarious right now.
Vicarious, yeah. And to my virtual left, because the great thing about virtual left is that it could be literally anyone, because it's virtual, it's not even real, it is Manimal, who we've already heard.
I'm ready to talk about child cartoons.
Okay, well, watch where you're going with that one and this. And to his left, finally, still alive, still chugging away, it's Nebons.
Hey, I've been working, I think, a total of like 24 hours in the course of the last, I don't want to say 24 hours, but it's been a doozy of a day, fellas.
Oh, shit.
Oh, my word. That
you sound tired.
I'm a little bit tired.
I am with you. I've not quite worked that long, but I feel like I have been literally, it's been one of them weeks where I'm up, going to the office early, leaving the office late. Going to bed, getting up, like, and just trying to fit life around that. That's all ended. I'm officially free for 8 days. It is plain sailing, so we've got some spiced apple Koppenberg cider, which is all lovely and festive.
I am celebrating.
It's a Sunday night, but it does... Oh, shit, I've just timestamped the episode. It's a mystery day.
Good going.
It's a mystery day. You know, I've got some alcohol. We are celebrating, and what better way to celebrate Christmas?
Actually, we're having a bit of a kistery tonight.
We are. We're going back.
We're going to talk about Vinny Vincent versus Bruce Kulick.
Vinny Vincent versus who?
We're talking about kistery, or the other kind of kistery.
What's kistery?
The history of the band Kiss?
Ah.
Or the history of Lego's kisses. The file's empty.
And this kiss has some pretty good ecchi there.
Take it off.
Take it off, son.
Yeah. Is your mind getting dirty around 7:30 or 11:30? I don't remember what time.
I want to say it was 11:30. That was the decision we made.
How about Utada Hikaru? She's working 9 to 5. She's thinking about 6 to 9.
That one I do not know.
I get it.
Who's Utada Hikaru?
The greatest J-pop artist of all time.
Link me.
I mean,
Simple and Clean again.
That one's not.
Most
best.
People just
look up Deep
know
River.
Her from Kingdom Hearts.
Look up Deep River. Look up Keep Trying. Distance. Final Distance. If you want to shed a tear.
Sanctuary.
Because you do know your suspicious videos. Oh yeah, that's the thing, right? It even goes into the real realm sometimes. I learned that ever since I saw that video.
Kodakumi.
Kodakumi.
Kodakumi Juicy. Yes.
Oh my word.
That's Kodakumi is pretty interesting.
Okay, so I guess you should answer the question again. Your favorite ecchis, starting with we should go to virtual left, but Manimal's already.
Shouldn't we start with you?
Oh, ish. Oh, me. Okay, cool. My favorite ecchi anime, High School of the Dead. God damn it! I really don't review this. No game, no life. Okay, sue me.
Ah, get out of the house, you freaking freak!
Sue me, you bastard! Sue me! I dare you.
I got the law. I got Daredevil on my side. We're ready.
In the GABA.
I would sue you, but you can't, squeeze blood from a stone. So,
can we just rewind a second and just replay the clip that Lego said? I'm going to punch you in the GABA. I just want to appreciate that moment.
Okay, those are my two favorites. I won't go too deep into reasons, but... Oh, yeah, wait, sorry. I'll mention another. Bento. Bento, High School of the Dead, and No Game, No Life. Yes,
Bento,
those are my three.
Like,
and what about you, Corin?
No, I'm suddenly realizing I didn't really do any research for this episode, like I usually do when we have a theme.
Just go to anime lists, check the ecchi tag, something will...
No, I'm trying... to remember what it was called, but I don't remember what it is. So I'm going to throw out Rosario plus Vampire as being very fun. And I also really enjoyed watching Ecchitosen because it was dumb.
Oh my god, Ecchitosen. Oh man, that is actually relative to the theme that I was talking. That's an old school one, right?
Mm-hmm.
Well,
yeah.
They've been making new seasons like forever, as far as I know. I mean, I haven't kept up since I was probably like 18. But
yeah.
New seasons kept coming out. And there was another one that is slipping my mind right now. It's like at the cusp, but it's not quite there. I don't remember the name.
Like the cusp? What was the story?
It's not coming. It's really annoying.
That's every harem show, though.
It wasn't a harem show.
No, but that's the plot of every harem show.
Okay, it was. Okay, it was a harem show. It was. screw it. My brain's broken. Tengen something.
Tengen Toppa Gurren Lagann was an Ecchi anime?
No,
kind of.
That's not what he's talking about, but yeah. I know what show you're talking about, Corin. I don't know what the title is either.
Yeah, it's a bunch of high schoolers that fight each other and have
magical
powers.
Yeah, I know exactly what you mean, but I forget the title.
Is it the one with the boobs where they suck?
No, it's older.
Lego, you're talking about a pretty interesting title. I know what's that one called?
Opa no Quelza.
Yeah, that one. That one's kind of, yeah. It's in the same realm of Valkyrie Drive Mermaid. And that one show where the girl gets anally fisted in the first episode.
You're joking.
Oh, dear.
It was that bad? Oh, my
word. Is Quasar Stigmata the one with breast milk alchemy?
Yes.
I'd like to thank my friend Other Brian for introducing that concept to me.
The Other Brian.
Other Brian. And then this Brian introduced the concept to me, and I've never been the same since.
You guys have ended. Okay, you guys are dead to the world. So far, I haven't implicated myself too badly. You also what? Sorry.
I also enjoyed Sekirei? Sekirei? Sekirei.
Yeah, they didn't go into
one that was Pokemon.
Realms.
Yeah, I know what you mean.
Is that the one with the zombie girl?
Yeah, exactly. I was scared of watching it because of that.
The zombie girl. But basically, the whole concept is Sekirei. There's like genetically modified human beings that get like collected by other genetically modified human beings, and it's sort of like a Pokemon situation where everyone's trying to take over the world with superpowers.
Okay, maybe that isn't that one.
That is another one. I think that's Punchline.
Punchline. That's the one where the guy like blows up if he gets an erection, right?
Yep, he blows up.
I remember seeing ads for that. Security.
I watched the first episode of that show. I thought it sucked.
I know.
No, not that it sucked. I couldn't get into it very much. I didn't like it a whole lot.
Same here, and I kind of want to go back and finish it because I've heard it goes in interesting places, but I don't know.
I'm sure it does.
You traitors, give it a chance, please. I'll watch whatever you guys recommend, please.
They literally just said they might go back and watch it.
I mean,
calm
I'm going to recommend good shows, so it's okay, Lego.
Okay.
Vacant, I believe, is next.
Me? My what? Favorite ecchi anime?
Yep.
That's why we're here.
Oh, that's a tough one. Okay, I'm gonna say either Kiss X Sis, I kind of ruined the joke when I haven't been able to say it. Kiss X Sis, or
did you like the
Boku
armpit
no
part
Pico?
The most?
I never watched it. Okay, you called my bluff.
You freaking poser.
I love that part. I love that part.
Don't try to cover your tracks.
I've heard it's a really good one as well. For me, I guess Newcom. Would you class Newcom as
a
what?
Newcom. I mean, it's got a really, really, really long title. It's just like
my mental choices are disturbing my what or something like that. I don't know.
Oh yeah,
it's basically the high school kid. Yeah, who's like God. He's cursed by gods, so he gets random choices in his life, and he has to do one of them, and they're normally embarrassing. That's a good one. Would you class that as ecchi, or...?
It has ecchi in it.
Would that count?
So for whatever that's...
Yeah, I think that one counts. There's anime, they have varying levels of ecchi.
Would you class Chobits as an ecchi as well, or no?
Chobits, I haven't seen it, but I'm pretty... Well, I mean, it has nudity in it, but I don't think it's necessarily an ecchi.
It's got a nice romance story.
I know, it is quite a vanilla romance. Like, I'm going off ecchi, like the ecchi tag from my anime list. Oh, obviously, High Schoolers is dead, I've seen.
You could mention it. It's the same problem with romance, right?
I guess it's not in the... It's not in the same vein as like a kind of hog, like full on Ecchi, I don't think.
Yeah, it's not in the same vein, but it does have its moments, I assume.
I'm trying to think of one that was actually good. Newcom was good. Bakano Test, that's got loads of
Bakano
Ecchi.
Bakano Test is good. I don't know if I ever classified it as Ecchi in my mind.
It's got
though.
A lot of fan service. Yeah, maybe. I guess
I mean, it has fan service, but what doesn't anymore?
I guess
fan
service
doesn't count as Ecchi.
Okay, yeah, no. I'm fucking it up. What about Haganai? Would you class Haganai as a
It's Ecchi? More of a harem show. I mean, it has a lot of Ecchi in it. It has like the sunscreen part and some other stuff.
I will just go with Newcom and High School of the Dead then. Maybe Fairy Tale, because that's gone pre Ecchi recently.
Lots of butts.
Oh wow, Fairy Tale there. Oh my word. Yeah. Strip Lucy, he needs body heat. Oh man, that was interesting.
Yeah, that's just, yeah, that's by the by.
And there?
You know, no, I'm kind of going down the list of what is and isn't Ecchi, because I've seen a couple of like romance shows, like My Monster Secret is a great show that has occasional scenes, or more specifically, characters who are the Ecchi part.
Oh, the wolf girl.
Yeah,
yeah.
Who's sometimes a dude.
Yeah.
What?
Yeah.
Yeah. Watch that show. It's adorable and really funny.
The manga is good too. That's what I'm reading it as it comes out over here. It's decent.
Huh. It's also, I think, one of the few manga that's, you know, characters end up dating.
Oh.
Ah.
Interesting.
That is actually.
And, then I remembered I did watch Ecchi So, which is just Mon Musu.
Monster Musu.
Which
that is?
Oh my word!
Monster Again. Or Everyday Life with Monster Girls.
That's I can't do the life. Main guy in that show. He's literally too lame. I can't watch it because of that.
Yeah, at some point I think they have more shots with him with the big round white reaction eyes than they do.
A real face.
Eyes.
I know. Yeah. He's literally. I mean, I get that it's supposed to be the self-insert character, but I don't like that in any show.
Yeah.
To be honest,
he's kind of a lame-o, but he is the vehicle with which we are introduced to Monster Girls.
Who's your best one there? Spider Girl. Don't say anything else.
See, if you're asking which is best girl, is it of the six who are in the house or all the possible girls? Because
the
best
ones.
Girl is Tianesia, the ogre woman, the Oni.
The one eye?
She the best.
Oh, man.
No. The giant lady who's strong and buff.
Oh, I don't know.
And she's got
one.
The big horn in her head, and she just like picks up a dolphin that one time and is casually stealing a dolphin from the aquarium as a pet.
Okay, that's best girl just for being cool.
Yeah.
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 Right on.
Other than that, best girl is, I don't know.
Spider Girl. What's her
name?
I
kind of like it's Snake, Spider, Horse are the three tops.
Can I just throw a random question? So if you had to combine a girl with any animal, what would it be? Answer, Lego. I just want Lego's answer.
Just
you
Legos.
You knew my answer.
You
don't.
Do.
Cats.
Oh, yeah, Lego, you should check out the third special for Maso Gakuen. I'm going to send you something. I want you to live react to this.
Oh, God.
Me.
In the meantime, we can keep talking.
Okay. Here's me keeping talking.
Oh, I'm just realizing some of the old ones I used to watch way back in the day.
Back in the day.
Like, well, there's like Kanokon, which I was really good. Well, I don't know, it's really good. I enjoyed watching it. There was Bokutsu Tenchi Dokuro-chan. That's a long one.
What's that one?
That one's like an angel or something gets stuck on Earth and she takes the dude as a slave.
Bludgeoning death angel?
Repeatedly.
She keeps murdering him.
Oh, this show! I was going to watch this at some point. Yeah.
It's really funny, man.
Yeah, I mean to watch this one. Yeah.
I'm flashing back to like the times before I had high speed internet when I would have to go to the college or like the nearby library and rent the few anime DVDs they had. And like the first three volumes of Mabaraho or God, Girls Bravo.
Oh, Girls Bravo. Oh my god, I watched the first episode of that for my anime roulette thing. It was so bad.
Yeah, but, you know, that's what we had.
Yeah.
It was all garbage and also Cowboy Bebop. And that's what I started with. Oh, and I thought, okay. Oh man, anime's great.
Then you watch Girls Bravo and you're like, oh.
It just got bad.
Yeah. Here, Lego, live reaction. Slowly flip through these pictures.
Oh, wow. That is an interesting website.
Okay, that's an interesting URL right there.
We have to be careful about what we put in the link up this time around.
I mean, it literally is what you think, but here, Lego, get a live reaction to this special.
It's literally blocked on my. Okay, now I can see.
That's probably a good reason it's blocked.
Oh my god, I can't go further than that. I am done. I am done at the tail. I am done.
I'm scrolling down.
I am done at the tail, bro. Oh my
goodness.
I'm saving that for later, but I can't live react to that now.
I see the tail you're talking about. Later.
Oh my god. Happy New Year, Lego.
I've just found the tail.
Thank you, Manimal.
Should all acquaintance be forgot and ever brought to mind.
I did find that old anime I was talking about, though. Tenjo Tenge.
Yeah, yes. That's true. Yeah,
that one's fun.
Tenjo Tenge. Oh, great.
Okay. Yeah, so that's that.
That was that. Hey, I'll talk about my favorite shows now. Shimonetta. There's a great ecchi that has a purpose for having ecchi, for one. Commentary element to it, while also being spicy and cool and fun and just a generally great show. In the last episode, they play Han and Leia's theme. That was incredible.
That is a great show.
Yeah, it's great. The show was awesome. And then Prison School, obviously, that's a really funny show. That's a good one. What else? I liked Bikini Warriors. I thought that did what it was supposed to do. It was pretty entertaining.
Oh, crap. Yeah, I forgot about Prison School, too. There was a couple shows in this past year that were, you know, they had enough plot, you forget they were kind of porny.
Yeah, because Prison School
did have a lot of plot going on.
Prison School had a lot of, like, seeing their plans and everything was, like, actually pretty fun. And, like, the whole thing with, like, the players and everything. It is a fun show. And
Sorry, getting sidetracked for a second. So do we count shows like Monogatari as ecchi, even though it has the stuff?
Oh man, the toothbrush scene is a legendary.
It has the stuff, but it's not really about the stuff.
I see. I don't know.
Does it have the stuff?
Ooh.
Well, I guess that's a
common. It's not like flagrant about it sometimes.
I mean, that one cat girl. Yes, but. And then like Setekai Yakondamo is not really an ecchi, even though it's about all that stuff. Is This a Zombie was a pretty watchable show. Data Live was fun for a little while. The Data Live 2, that delivers the scenes. Other than that, there's not. Kaijo from this season is excellent. That's a great show.
What's Kaijo? I like
it. That's the one
Kaijo.
Where they battle
you
with the boobs
Kaijo?
And the butt. It's actually a great show. I like it a lot. It's a lot of fun.
No. It sounds like a horror manga that I no, wait. I'm totally mistaking the spelling.
Keijo is the one with the titty fights.
Yeah. Get your information.
Keijo has titty hypnosis.
All he needed to know.
Get your information straight. That's just some that picked. I could think of the top of my head that are worth watching and good.
It is clicked. It has clicked.
I mean, can you really count Panty and Stocking in a way, but not really?
It's more.
But the transformation scene
has its moments, but yeah. But like, you can count any magical girl show at that point with transformation scenes.
Yeah, but Panty and Stocking
Stocking definitely dealt with more sexual themes, but it wasn't in the way of, hey, look at my tits.
Yeah. So it was a lot.
Although there were several parts where they said, "Hey, look at my tits."
Sure. Yeah.
But the best part of the show is the monkey. That was incredible.
The best part of the show is just Garbelt. I thought like that.
Yeah.
One just showing him going around for years and years and years.
That was really good.
That's legendary.
That whole show is excellent. If you haven't watched it yet, go out and watch it, and don't feel bad either.
Amazing.
Make sure you watch the dub too.
Oh yeah, Kill la Kill.
The dub's
if
way
we
better.
Want to count Kill la Kill as well. Kill la Kill technically Kill is Kill. A super ecchi show, but again, like Shimonetta, it has a purpose to do so as it's connected to its plot and overall metaphors.
And by the time you're done with Kill la Kill, it's not even going to register anymore.
No, you don't even think about it.
Because Kill la Kill starts with the main character going, oh my goodness, this costume is a little bit skimpy. But the whole series ends in a giant naked cuddle puddle and it doesn't even register.
Well, I mean, the bath scene with Sasuke's mom.
It was a little rapey. And by a little,
that was the intention, though, to show like how evil she was.
Yeah, but that's like, okay in anime. Girl-on-girl rape is not rape, apparently, according to anime.
Still rape.
Oh, no. It was super rape in that scene. But yeah, they got it across.
It was purposeful.
Real
though.
Good. It's like supposed to hate rainbow hair.
The point is, Kill la Kill handled nudity really well and like maturely almost, which is a weird thing to say. But it did.
It did. Yeah, it's a great show. Freaking Trigger, best anime studio in modern history. We'll talk about them later on the winter preview, which hopefully came out by the time this does.
It will.
Time travel again. So do you guys have any preferences between old school ecchi and the new nice clean graphics?
I mean, new stuff's better because the old character designs aren't as good, really.
That's kind of it. If the whole point is to be titillated, make the art good, and not,
not
90s
skinny.
Bug-eye anime.
The freaking like, skinny legs.
Your eyes are half the height of your head, and
absolutely
your nose is 15
tiny
inches long. It's a little weird.
Yeah.
Oh, God, the old beak face anime designs?
Beak face, oh, yeah. That was
when,
the it
when
right
you,
there.
Weren't you a fan of the beak face? Come on.
No, oh, like early Yu-Gi-Oh! Episodes, or what was that old kind of sort of mecha?
I'm trying to think now.
I think Yu-Gi-Oh! Just has terrible designs in general, to be honest. But
hey, Summon Skull is the best ever.
I don't know, monster designs can be fun, but like,
okay, but that's
Kaiba
like...
is not an attractive person. Yeah. None it's of the people
like
who
17.
Are told is attractive.
What are you talking
are
about?
Attractive.
Not Joey Wheeler.
Joey Wheeler is not an attractive man.
I'm the most attractive man in all of Brooklyn.
Joey Wheeler? Are you serious? Is that a real name?
Kuna
Is he like a wheeling dealer? He's like a guy named Johnny Wheeler.
A little bit.
He's an Italian American.
I'm Joey Wheeler. Yeah.
Hey, Yugi, why are you gonna play all your Yu-Gi-Oh cards?
I'm gonna look up Johnny Wheeler right now.
Duel Monsters in the anime.
Joey Wheeler.
Joey Wheeler. Okay, I looked up Johnny Wheeler, and apparently it's some kind of wine. So I guess that's
a
little different.
Baby Dragon in the chat mode.
Wait, this guy's like one of the main characters. That's his name.
Yeah,
yes.
Joey Wheeler.
What?
At all?
I didn't watch this show. I hated this stuff, man.
Oh yeah, I forgot. It didn't have enough girls in. It had Taya, and that was it.
Oh yeah, one of
and it also and had my Valentine.
Yeah, she was shit.
This guy's face is amazing.
But she had.
We're gonna have a falling
sisters.
Out over which Yu-Gi-Oh! Girl is better.
Oh, there's a picture of him wearing a sailor uniform.
Yeah. What was my question? That's it. What makes something an ecchi? In your own words, we'll go around the table. Everyone decide what makes an ecchi.
When it gets juicy and it
candy
what
shots.
Does that mean?
When it gets, has the kind of content in it and it gets down to it, it's a very specific thing, obviously. And
what makes because there's a lot of shows that we've brought up as ecchi that were just fan service heavy. Like
a lot of them are just like harem shows and stuff that has the cast of. A lot of them are just copy and paste kind of shows that have all your favorite character archetypes that you're made to choose your favorite of and self-insert yourself to the main character as he goes around to all of them and has various activities in which he gets blue balls.
Okay. So, Manimal just said a lot. What about you guys?
I mean, I'm going to say if they're really, like, pushing that angle of the show and not... Like, you can have a fan service heavy... show without it being an ecchi, I think.
Mm-hmm.
You know, go back to Monogatari because it has a lot of fan service, but it's not about it.
What
at
about
all.
Code Geass?
Code Geass is probably ecchi. In the same vein of like there's a lot of fan service, but it's not about it. I think to be classified as an ecchi, it really needs to be obviously this is what this show is about.
It needs to be what's that one show called? Never mind.
Freaking
it's like defining pornography in the U.S. Supreme. No, I know, like, but the Supreme Court had to define pornography, and the end argument was, I'll know it when I see it.
I know pornography. If I can see a tit, or if I can see the minge, then that's pornography.
Not unless it goes in, like, just
no,
seeing...
No, if you see it, there's like, tasteful nudity that's not pornography.
Yeah, exactly.
Ghost in the shell.
I'd still bless it.
Every time there's a nip, it doesn't mean it's porn.
Netflix did a docurama recently, right? It's about a Commodus, the Roman Empire, the guy from Gladiator.
Mm-hmm.
But it's like a true story. There's a lot of tits in this documentary. Narrated by the guy who dies, Sean Bean.
The guy pretty who dies.
But there, he is the guy who dies.
Narrated by Castro?
No. Oh,
get that.
Hello, it's David Bowie and Fidel Castro. Today, we're going to talk about ancient Rome.
Yeah.
See, that's what we're going to do. Thank you, David.
Seriously? That's another accent.
But my point is, there's a lot of tasteful nudity in that show. Some
of course.
Very nice sets of breasts. Mm-hmm. But it's not porn.
There's a pretty big difference.
Okay, for me, I think it's like the romance tag, basically.
It's like you wouldn't go into the Louvre and see a nude and say, that's pornography.
I would.
I would.
Well, you're not.
Where it is, I mean, come on.
What about Spice and Wolf, right? The first episode. Hey?
I'm going to say not ecchi.
Exactly. No. But that's tasteful nudity, right?
It is.
Okay.
And it makes sense within context.
Yeah.
Nah.
Like, if there is a purposeful, we put the camera real low for no good reason, then it's ecchi.
Nah.
Yeah, I mean, things like Shimonita, and I think Monster Musu is that borderline of what's the point? Is it a plot or something reinforced by the titties, or are the titties taking the wheel itself? What's driving this
titties
car?
Titties take the wheel?
Those must be some pretty handy titties.
They're a handful, let me tell you.
I love the power of imagination, because the image that the mental image that you just conjured there was amazing. I just don't know if it's my hands or if it's my titties.
Yeah.
What's
but no, see, yeah,
steering wheel like, would have to be shaped like hands for them to be able to cup properly and then be stirred properly.
Oh wow, you're going that direction.
I don't know.
That's interesting.
That would titties be take the wheel.
That'd be a hell of a
I'm
beat.
Letting go.
We, you know, I'm betting we could probably see this exact thing at like the Alabama State Fair or some shit like that.
Guaranteed.
Just some woman driving her tractor with a titty.
Exactly.
Say good lord! No hand. I don't know why the freaky voice comes out all the time.
Preacher voice is gotta build maybe for something.
I want to visit that church. That's
church.
A congregation I want to meet.
You got the Southern Baptist Church going, good lord, look at that woman's titties.
Oh,
and I was saved.
They were crafted by the hands of God. Say hallelujah.
And God was smiling that day when I looked across the road.
How is it that Lego does the worst impression out of all of you?
You just what? Just what?
What?
The rest of us have a little more experience with Southern Baptists.
Yeah.
Are you saying the guy from England has never been to Alabama? Actually, no, you have been to Louisiana. What the hell?
I've been to Louisiana. Yeah, man, I'm talking from fucking experience. You bust your accents out then, manimal.
This is my accent.
Put him on a platform.
I've been using a fake voice the whole time.
I did always think your voice was quite low for how old you are.
Oh, yeah, this isn't my true voice. I'll reveal my true voice on episode 1000.
Hey, guys, my name's Manimal.
Like, it's too low. I don't get it. I think you use voice modulator, which I may use for this episode for myself.
He's just sucking in helium all the time.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Anyways, well, the other gas. What's the gas that makes your voice go low instead of high?
Are we going to get back on topic, or are we going to talk about...
Let's get back on topic. So
Asner was saying, with Shimonetta, the whole story is centered around that. So stuff like that happens, and there's metaphors, and they're doing all these crazy things related to the topic the whole time. So it's obvious.
Okay. You know. So fan service is just window dressing. Ecchi is the core, one of the main pillars of the plot.
Yeah, like the Kaijo. In Kaijo, it's not really fan service in Kaijo because the plot is what they do.
Okay, fair enough. That's that clears it up a little bit.
Mm-hmm. What makes a good ecchi?
Something that's fun.
That's your expertise, mate.
It's got to be fun. It's got to have some semblance of a plot.
Depends what you're looking for.
Yeah.
Good
again,
art.
It's something that's fun. Like, all the shows I mentioned, they're all fun. They're funny. They do have somewhat of a story. You know, even Kaijo does. It has good characters with goals and all that business and stakes.
I like the characters in Kaijo. I like the main character's motive. She's just there for the money.
Yeah, Nozomi is great. Like, I like these characters a lot, and you kind of feel they're not just like there to be like, oh, look at me. You know, like, they have some kind of definition and goals and motives and all that business. So it's just more about, it's not just looking at, it's not fast food, it's not just McDonald's. You know?
Ecchi ain't McDonald's. It's a good old steak.
Yeah, like, it has more purpose to it, and it's like, this is what we're doing. It's not just thrown in there to be like Phantom World, because that show did not have a solid story or character base to go off of. So it was like, here's Boob Limbo.
Okay, because that's what I was going to say, just in regards to, I guess it's what you're looking for. But to me, if you're specifically searching and seeking out an ecchi show, then you're looking just for art quality, I guess, like Nair said. Like, you're looking to see some well-defined tits and ass.
Of course.
If you're just specifically seeking out an ecchi. If you happen to watch a show that isn't ecchi, because I guess that's the initial hook, but then, yeah, like you said, you need a plot. You need strong character. Like, any story, basically. That's just one of the grabs. It's like, I guess if it's a mecha show, like, you go, I like mechas. Let me get involved in this shit. And then you go in. And hopefully it's a good story and carrots to back it up.
Yeah, and again, you know, it doesn't need a big story. No show needs a big story as long as it has enough of a dynamic and overall some sort of narrative.
Like, comedy again, works best for ecchi.
Yeah.
In my opinion. It's absolutely true. Easiest, but you cannot... I mean, I'm yet to see a really, really serious ecchi. I mean, I'm not an expert by any means. But
well, like, what's a serious... There's a lot of serious ecchis that I can't think of them off the top of my head, though.
Comedy and nip slips go hand.
Like high school, High School DxD is still kind of funny. I think I only watched a couple. It was really funny. I watched some of the dub for number 3 actually at a con, and they had some of the voice actors there. They're doing a live commentary of it, and Funimation totally made a joke out of the show. That was great. That was really funny. But
it makes sense though, because like, School Days has like elements. But,
School Days.
You know,
School
Days
super
takes depressing.
It serious. Yeah. And again, I would say that I like what School Days did. I like that it had the balls to do what it did. And it stood as something that everybody remembers. Everybody who saw the show at least remembers it. So, you know, the worst thing you can do as a show is be forgettable. You know?
Yeah, that's probably true. There's plenty of forgettable shows I've watched.
But I have never forgotten... the tingle on my spine at that last episode of School Days, you know. That was a legitimate reaction. I was like, oh, God, you know.
I'll be honest, I was just glad it was over because I hated everybody in that show except Basketball Girl. She did nothing wrong.
Basketball Girl, yeah, right.
She was the best.
This is Corin telling School Days, you are the worst anime I have ever seen. And then School Days with the Jack Sparrow hat goes, but you have seen me.
Yeah. No, School Days, at least, like, I like that it's such a breakdown of romance shows. It's like, what if the guy just went all in? He's like, you're not going to mess around. And that's what I like about it, that it had the balls to do something like that instead of all these other shows where the guy's like, I don't like that at all. You know, like, it's like, shut up. Yes, you do, you idiot.
Yeah, but there's a difference between going all in and being a psychopath.
That's true. That is, and having no morals or care for anybody.
He didn't. He literally was just a psychopath. He didn't give a shit about anybody or anything.
That's true. He didn't care about Katsura or any of them. Yeah. But School Days is something that I think by now everyone knows the spoilers. If you somehow don't, just watch it.
Everybody dies.
There was a nice boat.
There was a very nice boat in that show, let me tell you. But see, if we want to talk about ecchi, something like Konosuba has a lot of ecchi in it, but it doesn't even faze me because the show is so good that it's just, and it fits the crude style of, especially with the art and everything in that show. And, you know, when I watch Konosuba, I don't remember the succubuses more than anything else, you know.
Or do you?
No, because the succubus...
the first thing thing you brought up.
The succubuses look really awkward, actually.
I did entirely forget about the succubus episode.
See?
It's more just explosion.
Oh, I can't. I'm so happy they're making a second season. It's going to be so good. But,
yes.
Konosuba is the best anime of 2016. We'll talk about that later, though. Anyways,
which one was?
Konosuba.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, man.
Like, the OVA episode of Konosuba is based around the main character gets a wish ring that doesn't grant him his wish.
Right.
It will just kill him if it doesn't get his wish.
That's right.
And so everyone in the cast starts trying to act as lewd as possible for him in the hopes that one of those will just be his wish, because he doesn't remember what his wish was.
What
was
it
in the
end
of it, they're all pissed. And they just leave him alone because they hate this asshole who's been abusing them for a week. And it turns out all he really wanted was some peace and quiet.
Yeah.
And when they're angry and gone, he's just like, oh, this is nice. And it doesn't kill him. That's the joke.
Konosuba
is
so great.
It works really well.
It does. That show is too good. But again, with ecchi shows, like, what makes a good one is just how fun it is to watch. And if it has some kind of beef or something to stand on beyond just, like, what's going to happen next. Like, Maso Gakuen, you only watch that to see what spicy stuff happens next, because the story is the worst. You know. And Big Order is basically like, hey, this show... it just had a bath scene in it, so you can buy the Blu-ray, basically. You know, that's the only reason it was there, because it knew that it was
Have
the
you got
worst.
Yours on pre-order yet?
It knew that it was the worst show in history.
But there was not enough ecchi in there.
Oh man.
That Blu-ray thing is cheap as hell.
Yeah, because it's only called Big Order because that's what it hopes to get. Actually, it was kind of sad because Kaijo's first Blu-ray didn't sell well at all because they didn't add any nudity in it, which I like. I like that Kaijo doesn't have nudity in it. It makes it more, I don't know what you'd call it, but... Maybe it broadens
more dignity
a little bit.
More.
Well, Kaijo isn't about having dignity necessarily, but it still handles things.
The creators might have some dignity.
It handles things with
a small shred.
I don't want to say that it handles things with class, but it handles things really well because it's not just like
this is
so embarrassing and it doesn't go that route. It's just like this is what they do, and it's natural and funny, you know. And that's why Kaijo is great.
I think we hit all the topics that we're going to hit for now. I wanted to do a game. It's going to be a short one, and it's probably easy knowing you people. So basically, first I'm going to ask myself, for example, okay, solar system. Choose a planet from the solar system. Then I have to say a planet or a heavenly body from the solar system. Then I have to say the moon.
It's a Sailor Moon thing.
Nope. Come up. I'll call it the innuendo game. Woohoo!
Okay.
Basically, you come up with innuendo in either a pickup line, or you just get lazy and ecchify whatever I choose. So for me, I've said moon. Then I'll have to somehow make that ecchi by making a pickup line using the word, or I can just say moon girls or something if I'm lazy.
I got you. That makes sense, actually. All right, but
I think pickup lines would be better. Just pickup lines, because that'd be
and just make it like random objects, not just planets. Like just totally innocent objects.
That's what I mean. I'll give you guys a theme. You choose something. You have to go with.
Yeah.
It, so.
All right. That sounds good. Let's do it.
Okay. Then pickup line. Moon. Nah.
Plagos talking to himself right now.
I like how you're struggling. You're the one who set yourself up.
Yeah.
this is bad, man.
Welcome to the Lego Solo Cast.
Baby, I'm like an ocean and you're like the moon. You pull me with your tidal influence.
Lego, you had something going there, but you didn't have the delivery. I'm sorry. I'm going to have to reject you.
Tidal influence.
I posted a website that generates lists of random objects, so just go off that.
Okay.
Oh, okay.
That was the dry run. Okay, Lego.
Oh, that was dry. A
very dry run indeed.
Oh my God. Thanks for the support. I enjoy it. Your next, Corey. Using the random list generator.
Am I picking my... Okay, so...
Do you want me to throw one at you?
Yeah, you shouldn't pick your own.
Okay, first of all, we should decide who's picking the object and what are the...
I'll pick it because I've got it off.
Yeah, but also, how do we win?
You just keep going. If you can't think of a pun in a reasonable amount of time, if you can't think of a pickup line in a reasonable amount of time, you are eliminated.
Okay.
We're going to go based off listener reaction. So everybody get typing, get your numbers ready, and see how much it got you going.
Yeah. It's like sweeps week.
Okay. Are you ready? I have just I've just clicked refresh. Here's one. This could be easy for you, Corin. Piano.
A piano. And we're doing pickup lines or just innuendos?
Pickup lines would be the best.
So would you just pick up lines? Like, what do you guys think? Yeah, just pick up lines? Okay, just pick up lines.
Pick up lines.
Oh my God. Do they have to be good pickup lines?
Corin, this one's so obvious.
Yeah, I'm burning.
Piano.
I really hope you're going to say what I think.
Are you a piano? Because I'd like to play you all night long.
Oh!
That's not what I was thinking, but that works.
Yeah.
That's a promise to be unfaithful to her.
That was nice.
Okay, Manimal, what was yours? Because I'm curious.
Are you a piano? Because I'm a pianist.
Hey.
Oh, no, that's not what I had either.
What did you have?
Mine was going to be, hey, how much do you think this piano weighs? Enough to break the ice? Hey, I'm Brian.
Oh, wow.
Hey, that does the job. That's nice. That's subtle. You know, good job.
And to your virtual left, Corin. That means...
Vacant.
Vacant is next. You have to give...
Going
someone...
to hit refresh on the list. Hold on. I'm refreshing, so... let's see.
You are very refreshing.
Thank you.
Oh, Nair is just going to win this so easily.
Sideways comp.
A candle.
Hey, who's getting married?
Candle.
Hey. Lucky bastard.
That's true. He is getting married. Hey baby, are you a lit candle? Because I can see you dripping already.
Oh shit!
Hey!
Oh my god! No! Oh my god!
Sorry.
Well, you're making me tingle in my nether regions.
Ooh, burning like a candle at both ends.
Who's after me?
That is
animal.
Animal after you.
Okay.
Okay. Give me one.
Well, that's a really shit one. I've just clicked it, and it just says food.
Okay, give me a more specific one.
You can change how many objects there are there.
Okay, refresh it, so you give me something.
I have a pencil.
Okay.
Well, shit.
This is a really good one for this one. I've got one for this.
Hey, are you a sharpener? Because my life is getting pretty dull. Are you a sharpener?
I don't know. What do you think, guys? Is that an out?
Let's give him one freebie.
Okay.
For pencil, much like candle, the question is, have you ever put blank in your butthole?
Oh, yeah, that's true. That's true. That was weak. That was weak.
Oh my god.
Oh, anywho, give me the next one.
I'm a real pencil pusher.
Nah, yours is. For God's sake, yours is floor.
That one's easy.
Mine is floor.
That's easy. Do you want me to spin again?
No. Hey, baby. This floor looks pretty good, but I think it would look better with your clothes on it.
Yep.
Hey! Wow. Yep. That was a good one. Lego, we are to you now, my friend.
This will end perfectly.
Okay, here's one for you. This is a tough one. I couldn't think of anything for this. This is toothpicks. So a toothpick.
Oh my
god.
Oh, I've got one. I have got one.
I am done. No, I can't do that one. I can't do that right
now.
Do it.
No, no, no. Toothpick.
Hey, baby, have you ever had a toothpick up your butthole?
Oh. It works. Because
I've got one for you right now. Start lowering your expectations for my penis.
Start lowering. I mean, it's already begun, but okay.
Terrific.
It's good to know. Good to know you have influence.
I forfeit.
Lego.
It's his game too.
Come on,
you're so bad at this. It's your game. No, come on.
No. You do two things. Okay, no one has done two things. Go on. No, I forfeit. I see. I can't.
Okay, Lego's shall we loser. Give you your freebie? Because Lego has... We've given Manimal a pass. We'll give Lego one pass.
It's okay. I'll try. Okay. I have something between my teeth. Oh, my God. No.
Could you lick it out for me? I don't know.
Wait until next round. You got one freebie. You got one life left.
You got a freebie. Who's next?
The little Lego face has disappeared from the top of your screen.
Who have we got? Corin next.
I'm next, and Lego should take the one for me.
Oh, okay.
Randomlists.com things. A door.
A door?
Yes.
Oh, come on. This one's easy.
Are you just saying that?
No, I've got one really, really. There's a really easy one on this one. And it's really cheesy.
I keep thinking of that stupid riddle, when is a door not a door, when it's a jar. Oh, it has nothing to do with the conversation, but it's that same stupid riddle.
Baby, why don't we go home and lock all the doors so nobody will disturb us for hours?
Oh, Corin, there's a more obvious one there.
I adore you.
Oh, I was gonna go with knocking.
Oh, God.
Knocking.
That's the one I got.
That's you know really that's good, Vake. That's a good one.
That's a really bad pun.
I know.
My brain doesn't think like that, man.
Corin can't do the bad ones. He can't do simple.
Erasing.
That kind of lower kind of humor and thinking and basic humor is my wheelhouse.
Here, I'll pick one for Nair. Or wait, did Nair go?
Yeah, it's my go next.
It's yours. Well, okay, then... I'll pick one for you.
Okay.
Balloon.
A balloon. Ooh. Hey baby. I feel like we create static. Because I'd love to rub up and down you all day.
Oh!
No! I should have said money.
Kudos for avoiding anything having to do with blowing. That's some restraint on your part.
I mean, true restraint is not going straight for the whole thing where people put balloons inside of them and blow them up.
Hey, we can get to that stuff later.
Not on this episode.
Yeah, this not is just the Ecchi episode. This ain't the Patchy episode. That didn't see the light of day.
Look, Ecchi's fine for Christmas.
Yeah.
Not
and that's
so much.
The name of the episode.
That's a good one. That's a good name.
Ecchi's fine that or Titties Take the Wheel.
Titties. No, that has to be the name. That's amazing.
I'm thinking that's going to be the thumbnail image. I'll try and edit something.
Commission an artist.
So, Manimal is next?
Manimal next.
All right, Manimal. I got it. Let's see. A mouse pad.
Ooh.
Okay. Hey. You got me running around in circles. Can I park?
What?
I lost the train of thought there.
I lose.
Did you ask if you could park?
Yeah.
That's what I was thinking.
Because you park your mouse in the mouse pad after you're done.
Wait, what do you think a mouse pad is for?
You park it.
You park it when you're done. You leave it there for the night.
Nobody calls it parking.
It's parking because it's a vehicle. It's a hand vehicle. It's literally a vehicle you utilize with your hand. Oh. It is.
Amazing.
It's accurate. That was an accurate metaphor. Don't even diss me.
I really don't know what I would have done with that, and I'm glad I didn't receive that. Seriously, someone...
I kind of don't want to say you're out, because that was amazing.
It's a hand vehicle. We're satisfied. Okay, no forfeiting. We have to do it no matter what, and then when we're satisfied...
A hand vehicle.
Yes. Okay. You know how they call like dollies like hand trucks and stuff? Like, yeah, a hand vehicle. Tech deck's a hand vehicle, eh?
The itty bitty skateboards.
You can transport things with it, which is technically the definition of a vehicle, right?
I remember this.
Like Tech Deck Pee Wee trick boarders. You can skate them, trade them, but don't underestimate them.
Lego. Oh, shit. Lego's next. Lego's next.
I remember and those old commercials.
It's Nair next.
It is Nair next.
Okay,
order me next.
But save that one for me.
Well, okay, I will save mine. I've just clicked refresh for Lego.
Okay.
So for you, Nair, you have shovel.
Oh
God, that can only be a murder instrument. You can't.
What?
What are you talking about?
It's a very easy one.
This is a very easy one.
Yeah. I don't know how I want to phrase it just yet, though.
Tick-tock.
Blow my speakers
you
up.
You know, girl, my wang is a bit like a shovel in that it plunders your big brown hole.
Oh, wow!
You're getting straight to business. You were pretty subtle before, but not anymore.
Yeah.
You've broken the ice with the piano.
Have you ever had a shovel in your butthole?
is that literally a solution to everything?
I'm going to declare right now that nobody can use have you ever had blank in your butthole or other oil.
Are you sure? Absolutely, they can. Right, this is a dare that's going to happen in London. Whoever gets
nobody
first.
Yeah. Nobody is putting a butthole. Nobody.
Are you
going to
do like a cattail?
Nobody is putting. I love that's my new favorite episode title. Have you ever had blank in your butt? Literally a solution to everything. I just want to use that for anything. It's just like, so you're a few weeks paying the rent late. It was in my butthole.
I mean, if you're smuggling it, going over the border.
What happens with the damn piano then?
Lego, anything is possible.
Okay. Well, that was.
You just gotta believe.
You just have to have faith.
Well, that was something. Lego.
Here, let's go. Are we doing one more round? Are we going around one more time?
Yeah, we're going around one more time. Then,
yeah. Okay, Lego, yours is pillow.
Come on.
Oh my god.
Come on.
I know this one. It's in my soul. It's deep in my soul. Regions of.
What? It's in my regions. That's what I'm going to say next time I don't know what I've got to think of something.
You're in my regions.
It's in my regions. But I can't think of it right now.
Baby, do you want to join my Satsuki collection. Oh my god.
Say it. You say
Lego,
it.
Lego, this is getting pretty dark.
Hey girl, I've already got my Satsuki pillow collection. Would you like to join it? I don't have anything.
So you're implying that you're gonna make this person into a pillow, meaning that they would stay motionless the whole time. That's
Lego
dark,
is
Lego.
Inviting this girl to a threesome with his hug pillow.
Oh, okay. Now that makes it all right. That's
which
all right.
Is fine.
That's perfectly.
Oh,
wait.
God.
So, like, would she go inside the pillow? These are questions that need answers.
These are. Okay. Was that us done, or do you want to do one more round?
Me and Corin and you, Bacon.
Okay, yes, we
all have to go one more time.
Yes, Corin. One more
time. Let me press refresh. You have... Oh, no, that's too easy.
Say
pants.
It anyway.
You can't have pants. That's too easy, surely.
It is too easy. Can't do pants.
And then it's just gone the other way.
Have you ever had pants on your butthole?
I hate when that happens.
No!
Sometimes I use it for acceleration.
Have you ever had pants up your butthole and then just give the girl a wedgie and run away? Yeah. Because your tactic at picking up girls is high school bullying.
I've done it right. I'm doing it right, guys.
Oh my god.
Your subject is a clamp.
What?
Clamp.
Oh, no.
Yeah, oh, that's no. better.
Oh, God. Oh, God. No, this is too dark.
There's a very obvious path you can go with this.
There's a very obvious path, and this is too dark for Christmas.
Oh, we already talked about the cat girl, though.
Oh, God. No. Yes, actually. I'm going to...
Baby, are you into German dungeon porn? Because I just want to put clamps all over you.
Oh, my God.
Now, here's a question. For those who are like, who are in Germany, like Lego, would they have to specify German dungeon porn? Or is it just called dungeon porn? What do they call French kissing in France?
I don't think they call it Canadian bacon here.
I didn't think that was just the question you were going to ask.
Shit, I'm picking your next one.
Okay. I thought your question was, have you ever had a clamp in your butthole?
I hate when that happens. I need prune juice.
Jesus.
Okay. A car air freshener.
A car air freshener.
One of those little pine trees you hang around.
Okay. Let me see.
Ah, I've got a stupid one. That's nice.
But it's Oh no, that shit. That I was gonna say. Hey baby. Are you a car air freshener? Because I'd like to see you dangling from my dashboard.
Ooh. Wow, that actually ended.
I don't know what that means.
Wait, you're doing it from like an aerial position?
Like murder.
Yeah, kind of that way.
Wait, what's it called? Sky poop? Do you guys know what sky poop?
What? No.
It's when you stand on top of the toilet and you turn around and you take a shit like that.
You what?
I honestly want to do that at one point in my life. Serious. I'd love to do that at some point.
Mine was shit, man. I'm sorry. I thought of, oh, you're a breath of fresh air.
Killer.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Very poorly executed hanging.
Actually, I mean, are you a dashboard air freshener? Because you're a breath of fresh air.
That one's
good.
That
would work.
See,
now that's what I was going to say. I was going to say that one, but I was like, it's too shit. So I just didn't bother. Who's next?
I guess me.
Oh, man.
It is Manimal. Okay, Manimal.
Redemption round.
This is redemption round. This is. You have a spring.
That one should be okay.
Hey. You're making me feel just like a slinky. Going down the steps to love at the end, which is the eventual goal of all of humanity as we gather together to do our daily lives, hoping to find the special one that our slinky will lead us to as the candle burns from both ends.
It was a redemption round, indeed.
That was a redemption.
That was poetry.
So, did you ever have a spring in your butthole?
Well, let me tell you about the time that I got into a pogo accident. It was not fun at all. But I did activate that special Halo super jump and get to parts of the world that no one's seen.
Oh my word.
Okay, just to round us off.
I was hemorrhaging.
This is an
and it was a blood gulch.
Shush. Oh no.
Your random object is Sharpie.
Oh no.
Okay, no! There is a podcast I used to listen to that had a whole character in their Dungeons & Dragons campaign named Sharpie because the creator once put a Sharpie in his butthole.
Oh! But if you go to Reddit, I found when I was perusing Ask Reddit, there was what's the weirdest subreddits that no one really knows about that you've ever clicked on, and I went on it was more concise than that question, but I clicked on it and it was just like I read it as butt sharpie with one T, not double T, and I was at work and I clicked on it and I was like, oh. Okay, that was something that I
wait, so you expected it to be like butt sharpie, like, oh, butt the sharpie.
Yeah, like, I was like, well, what's that mean? That doesn't make any sense, butt sharpie? And I just clicked it and I was like,
like, these punks committed graffiti, but with a sharpie.
But sharpie.
Yeah. Some business like that.
I was like, somebody, like, save someone with a sharpie, but no, it's just people sticking sharpies in their butt hole.
You'll never believe what this kid did with the sharpie next.
English professors
the sharpie challenge gone wrong. 10 million views.
Gone sexual in the hood.
Where and else?
So oh my word.
I mean, where else are you going to go sexual?
Cheating stationary prank. My compass has been cheating on me. Don't let me catch you measuring with another man.
Oh, that kind of compass. I thought you were in like a relationship with your Garmin GPS lady.
My sextant? Isn't that what it's called?
A sextant? Yes.
Oh, man.
Oh, man.
This is the most shared episode. We're having a great showing tonight.
I have heard some things.
Okay, for a Sharpie, okay. It'd be like, hey, girl, I've got the Sharpie. Why don't you write your number on my hand?
Going back to mousepad, it's
for very specifically mousepad. You could have done, "Hey girl, your chest is like a mousepad. It's perfectly flat, and I want to lay my hands on it."
Oh, oh, wow. Nair is exposing his preferences live on air tonight.
I mean, not even, but like you
I
know,
something about mouses. So I was like, "Oh, the old school ones. Are you an old school mouse?" Because you could trap my balls.
Where?
Hey, Nair.
The pillow one.
Hey, Nair.
The damn pillow one.
Yes.
Pillow one. Would you agree that Lolly should be S in size and personality?
I.
What was the question?
Should Lolly's be S in size and personality?
In terms of small. Or like S rank as in so good.
See, Nair isn't even. Never mind. Let's end this freaking show already.
Yeah, let's end this while we still have a reputation.
I think Nair won the puns.
Nair won. I'll just give in. I didn't even try. I lost. But I didn't think of any forfeit for this thing.
Forfeit. Oh, Lego, you just reminded us. Of course we've got to have a forfeit. Okay, so Lego, here is your forfeit. Okay, do you know how the musical extravaganza is coming up in a few days?
Uh-huh.
You need to record a song, but you have to combine Ecchi and Christmas.
Oh,
somehow,
shit.
You've got to do that.
Yeah.
Oh, my.
Yes, please.
Dancing through the sleigh.
And you can't just sing Santa Baby.
Yeah, you can't sing Santa Baby. So
alternatively, you just sing Santa Baby.
Lego,
I really feel it.
I shall do it. But you know, it feels bad that the only thing that happens is some poor bastard does a forfeit. When do the winners get something out of these things?
The winners get to enjoy what the person who's done the forfeit.
Yeah,
he won. That's
they
a
get
point.
Hey,
fact,
Lego,
yeah,
Lego.
I really should choose that because he won.
Lego, I heard your sultry voice on SoundCloud.
Oh no! How did it appear?
What?
How did it appear there?
Because
you uploaded it.
I didn't upload it.
Yes, you did. It's literally on your page.
Your account.
I have no idea what.
It was
you're
a nice tune, Lego. You're humming a nice song. I'm not even dissing you.
Oh my god. Oh my god. The internet, they have eyes everywhere. I told you. By the way, my name is not Lego Maestro. I'm someone else. Anything that was said in my voice.
Mega Block Maestro has
risen
tonight.
I do not watch Ecchi. I'm a good, good guy.
He's a good Christian boy.
Yes! Oh man, okay.
Yeah. And that
Merry
is how
Christmas,
we conclude
everybody.
The Ecchi cast.
Please tell me you guys are coming on for the next episode. Please, come on.
The next episode?
Probably next year, but another episode. Come on.
Oh,
we're
God.
Not done talking about this.
If we have more things to say somehow. I feel like we said a lot in this hour, guys.
Yeah, okay. I'm signing off, basically. Unless, who closes this? Someone closes.
You're the host, aren't you?
You close, Lego, because you're the host.
I was the half-host. The half-host. Okay, parting shots, parting shots.
Yeah, I'm going to take one to the kneecap.
One to the chest.
For 500, Alex.
And
does Jeopardy have injuries in it where they just request Alex Trebek beat them?
Now this is getting back to my question there.
Are you just some kind of sadist who wants your sweet, sweet Alex Trebek to hurt you?
It's the other way around, because you'd be hurting Alex in that case.
Oh!
It's totally a yander.
Have we ended yet? Sorry, I've just been delivered McDonald's, so I've checked out.
Okay.
Yeah, my girlfriend just came in.
Okay.
There's nothing wrong with a 1 a.m. mid twilight McDonald's.
Oh yeah.
I'm never doing this hosting thing again.
I'm glad.
Have you ever had a Sharpie up your butt? This episode's podcast.
Bye, everybody.
McDonald's.
Bye. Bye. Merry Christmas.
Bye.
Merry Christmas.
Frickin'